Hello everyone, this is M here. Welcome to Logcast number 4. I know it's number 4 because I accidentally mistitled the last video in my files Logcast number 4. I hope my audio sounds better. Whenever I record in this application, it sounds better. You could hear it in the last, not the last video. I have to think, because I'm recording this, the week before this is going up. Not right after the last Logcast, like how I lied and said I would do, on Friday, but, on Thursday. So, you know, it's been an interesting morning. And I feel like we do have quite a few things to talk about. One, I found out that I can listen to music while I'm doing this. Because this will only pick up my voice. It won't pick up any audio that's coming out of my phone. Am I doing that right now? Maybe. A little bit. Yeah. number two. You know, I'm not the only person named that thought of the name Logcast. Like, I looked it up last night, and I found like 3-4 other people. I'm like, are you telling me I'm not a fucking genius? I'm not Jimmy Neutron, like how I thought I was this whole time? To be fair, one of them does not exist anymore. One of them has not uploaded in, I think, a year or two. The second one definitely still exists. But to be fair, it's different. Out of those three, all of them had co-hosts and all that stuff. I don't. It's just me for right now anyway. But you know, it's whatever. I also noticed I'm the only one who puts music in the background of the podcast. I know that's not usually how it's meant to go. Usually it's meant to just be someone talking for like an hour, but I feel like I have to compensate for the fact that it's just me. And that's my way of compensating for it. I thought about visually editing it, but I don't. Allow me to that's, show you people something. Don't usually do that, because podcasts are usually just put on in the background, so it's like, you know, no one's staring at the screen for like an hour. it's highly unlikely that someone's looking at the screen when they're watching or listening to a podcast, so I don't know about that. This, hopefully, will be the first Logcast with a thumbnail on it. That's just the thing that had to happen. The Logcast need a thumbnail. I don't know why I never made one before. I guess because I was like, does it need one? I don't know why I thought it didn't. Because the last three videos, they all have the exact same, like, thumbnail on them. No title or anything. It's kind of lazy, honestly. Allow me to show you something. So from now on, we're going to be, the Logcasts are going to have thumbnails. I like how this is slowly evolving. But like the first Logcast, you know, I don't even know what the title was. I think it was just Logcast. Logcast 1, I think that's what the name of it was. And then it turned into Logcast Part 2, and then I'd write the topics, and now we got thumbnails. We're moving up. I'm thinking about making my own custom avatar so I don't have to keep using Marauder for everything. But that'll be in the future. I don't know about right now. Right now that doesn't sound like the best idea to do. But we'll see. We'll see. Anything else I want to say on the channel? I think I mentioned it last time. How I was ahead. I was a lot more anxious the last Logcast. So far ahead, I don't even know when I recorded that, but all I know is on that Logcast I had the whole week done except for Friday, and I didn't feel like editing a Friday video, and 2 days passed where I just didn't do anything, and I'm like, you fat fuck, you gotta finish something. So it's done now. So this whole week's done. Everything that I'm doing at this moment is going into next week. Y'all want to hear a funny, let me talk about the VTuber thing first. So, last time, I had mentioned, you know, I don't know about this VTuber, you know, I mean, she's cool, but she said the funny fuck word, so, like, I don't know, that cuteness thing don't hit the same. And the rest of them, I don't know, I kinda like them. I guess I'm a degenerate now, I don't know what, I like all of them. But the one that I said the funny fuck word I like her the most, bro, look, bro, listen, bro, I don't know how it happened. I know kind of how it happened. It was just a emotional burst this morning, right? So, because I recorded 3 things last night. Audio. I didn't edit any of it. Well, I didn't edit any of it at that time. I recorded 3 different things. She was streaming, but I was like, I'm tired. No, I edited 3 different things. I voiced over 3 different things, and I hit the bed, right? I wake up at, like, 5 o'clock, and it was like, oh, her stream just finished. I'm like, I'm out here sleeping, and she's streaming at, like, 4 a.m. I gotta get some work done. And I start editing, right? And I finish the video that's going up. Damn, it would have already went up by now. The video that went up Monday. And I look, and she's streaming again. I'm like, bro, you're just fucking my whole vibe up. I thought I was finally ahead of something, and you're making stuff while I'm sleeping and while I'm awake. Like, do you rest? This is unfair. It's machinery. I don't know. That awoken something to me, and I watched part of the stream because I caught it right after finishing editing, and I was like, what did they say? And that one Emmy Ritchie video, it's just a feeling in my heart, bro. Look, I sound like the Sith. I don't think I care. I don't know. I'm not gonna go like, I love her. Like, you know, I like her. A little bit. This is downgrading into middle school bullshit. But yeah, I guess I like her. I think she's my favorite VTuber right now. I think I've fallen into that rabbit hole. I don't know. I don't like a ton of them. It's mainly just her, but how did this happen? How did this end up happening? How did I become this? Me from like 2 weeks ago would go like, ugh. You're disgusting. Okay. Something funny happened when I was editing. Well, multiple unfunny things happened while I was editing. Let's talk about that first. I was gonna edit the whole video, one long stretch, right? The audio was like 50 minutes long, but there was a lot of stuff I could have cut out because I recorded it really late, so a lot of it was me going, it's like, bro, do you know how to talk? And then I was listening to the boss themes like I said I would, and I most likely cut a lot of me listening to the themes out, but that took up a significant amount of time. And I was like, bet. It's just me sitting through stuff I can't even fully remember because I was kind of tired when I said it. And I'm editing it, and what was the first problem? I'm trying to think because there's a lot of problems. The first problem was the cropping fucked up. I don't know what happened. Like, I know it was, I recorded it off my phone. So, you know, it's gonna go up like a column because that's how all phone footage is unless you flip it sideways. Which I don't think I could have done that and shown as much as I wanted to. So I was like, whatever, I'll just put it in the editor. And then, you know, it'll just be blank space right there. Which probably will not happen in part 2. Part 2 is probably already up. This is the thing. I gotta talk as if I know I did it already. Damn, I don't. Right at this moment, I don't know what that looks like. But I probably put a background on the second one. So I'm like, okay, the cropping's messed up. I gotta install another app to get rid of this cropping issue. Because the editor itself would not let me crop it right. So I downloaded another editor. And then I go back into the original editor, because I needed both of them. I just needed one to fix the spacing of the video, and then I had to go back. So I go back, and then all sound from my phone stopped. All of it. Like, not even just the editor. Like, I couldn't hear anything. I suddenly went deaf for like 20 minutes, and I'm out here. What the fuck happened to my video? Like, I was getting mad. I was like, bro, don't tell me I edited this whole thing and then the video, the audio's gone. And I opened and closed the app 3 times, nothing happened. I exported it, nothing happened, and I was like, okay. Now you're making me depressed. And now I gotta reset the phone. And if this reset doesn't work, I'm gonna have to re-edit most of it. I reset the phone and I'm like, oh, thank God. I missed an issue. I just remembered it, but I'm gonna go back to it. I was like, oh, thank God, the audio is back. Next problem, the one that I said I'm gonna go back to. I don't know what was happening in my editor, but when the point where I was talking in the credits and I was just like, yeah, I don't know what the fuck happened. I don't know what happened. I have no idea what happened at all. That whole time, I don't know what happened. It hit 5 minutes 25, I'm in the editor, the timeline's going, and then it just stopped. Like, it started going frame by frame, and I kept pressing play, and nothing was happening, so I couldn't see what I was editing, so I was like, okay, I have to cut the video short. So now it's gonna be a part 1 that is like 5 minutes, and a part 2 that might be like 20. That was not planned. That was not planned at all. I want y'all to know that was I would never put that in the script. It was not meant to be that long. But because of technical difficulties, it now is that long. I'll probably stitch them together in the future, because that sounds like the best idea. But nah, they hold me. What else happened? What else happened? What else happened? Something else happened after. I had went to... This one is all my bad. So these headphones I have with the mic on them, they're really big in the other end. One is an audio jack. The other one is... Other part is a USB end for if you plug it into your computer. And I was so done with editing that video, I was like, okay, fuck it. Just throw the phone on the charger. Let the video export. Sit in the bed for a second. You know, come back and then just upload it, like put it on the schedule and let it go up. Tell me why I thought my headphones were the charger. So I came back and my phone died, and I was like, what if my charger not work? And I looked and I was like, oh my God, my phone wasn't charging. It was such a dumb situation. I had to start laughing because I'm like, bro, really? It's horrible. That was not how that was meant to go. That was not how that was meant to go at all. But now it's been... This started in the AM. It's the PM now. It took a while. It took a while. And I finished the video, and like I said, I saw the stream, and when I saw, did I say her name last stream? Oh yeah, because I couldn't remember what her name was last podcast. It's Maury, I call her Maury Callie, because I don't remember her name. I still don't. I'm sorry, I know I just said I saw the stream, like, earlier, but I forgot it again. It's maybe Calipy? I don't know. But when I saw her streaming, I was like, bro... Huh? And she was streaming and she was tired and she was like, I'm gonna finish this first. I'm like, fuck. Slide that worth at work. I can't even learn English. I'm like, slide that work ethic over, bro. I don't know. Like, I do edit a lot. Hence why I'm ahead of myself right now. And I don't know what the date is because I'm recording these in the past. But, I don't know, that it just made me go like, am I working hard enough? Like, I know I'm ahead by a week, but can I be ahead by more than a week? Can I be ahead by 2 weeks? 3 weeks? I don't know. Like, I feel like This is going to sound really unhealthy. Until I pass out from editing for too long, I feel like I'm not going to feel like I'm working hard enough. I don't know. Because it's like, I'm in a very different situation from everyone else that I know right now. I don't know if I could get into it like that, but like, I feel like I just got to work harder on this. I don't know. Because usually my day is like, I'll wake up at 6, I'll edit till like 3 or 4, and then, or 1, 3, 4, or 1. And then I'll get up and I'll do other stuff. But I'm starting to think I should make that gap smaller? I don't know. Because everyone else thinks I'm not doing anything. It's, how do I explain it? This isn't meant to be a pity party or anything, but it's like, because the fact that most people go like, oh, you're not doing anything. And then I'm like, am I not doing anything? That fucks your whole motivation up. I'm gonna keep it straight with you. If someone tells you, are you really doing anything, and you're doing something, it's like, especially starting something like this YouTube channel. I know I got into this on one of like the last podcasts, but I don't think I got into it like that. But I'm gonna try to keep it short. It's the fact that I wake up and I'll just get on and I'll just start working, and then I'll get up and get around, and everyone else usually works later than I do. Like, they'll come back later than I do, because I start earlier than they do. But they don't see me working, so they're just like, are you doing anything? You're not doing anything, are you? And I'm like, you know, I just spent like 5 hours just trying to get a fucking video to work. But I guess I'm not doing anything. And when you hear it enough, it's like, I'm not doing shit. I'm sad now. Like, I don't know how to explain it. That hit me super hard, I think, like, 2 days ago. Because, like, 3 people told me that at the same time. And I was like, damn, man. Damn. And I had just had to scrap a video because it didn't turn out the way I wanted it to. And I was like, I don't feel good right now. And I went to sleep, and now I've seen this VTuber lady who just worked until she fell asleep, and now I'm like, man, fuck people. I don't know what else to say. I think I just gotta hit that point. I don't know. I just gotta not care. I already kinda don't, because you can see what I'm trying to do here, but I gotta not care more. That's what I should be trying to say. You know? Because even when I'm on, like, when I'm on break and I'm not doing anything, even though I'll usually work more hours than I'm not, if someone mentions, like, oh, you're just playing around, I'm like, I am. It fucks you up. That's what I'm saying. Like, I mentioned it last time. Like, I talked about a lot of this last time, but you gotta stick with me because I'm feeling it right now. Like, that whole mindset of, since you're home, you could always be doing something. And it's like, mentally you can't. Mentally, you, like, you know, okay, that's not a human thing that you can always do the whole time, all the time. But, when someone tells you you should be working, or you can tell that they're looking at you like you should be working, it's like, fuck, I feel bad. So then you don't feel like doing anything else. There's a lot of times where I'll go to play a game or something, and then I'm like, I don't feel like playing anything now, because y'all just fuck my whole vibe up. I don't know how to explain it. That's just how it is. That's just how it is. Even though I know it's not true, that peer pressure fucking me up. I don't know what to say. But, I just started rambling. Golly, I went off. I don't know. I'm motivated. I'm really motivated at this very moment. I'm most likely gonna cut the stream off, and like I said, I'm gonna edit till I fall asleep. I don't, like, unless I gotta, you know, eat or something. Like, I know a lot of people go like, listen, where I came from, I had to work till I was tired, but I'm like, no one's gonna fucking care until I do something with it, so I might as well just do that anyway. Like, what's it matter? When you're starting an independent thing, it's not like it matters. Like, who's gonna, But the boss gonna go like, if you had a boss, I'm talking to fake, they wouldn't care. They go like, damn, this nigga working hard, he gave me my paycheck. That's trying to be, I'm trying to be that for myself. You feel me? I don't know. These really, I don't know how to explain these, but these really do be hitting different. I keep saying that. I say that more and more. And I don't want that to be a habit that I just say in everyday life. Be like, swiping the bus, the trans pass don't work. Damn, it do be hitting different though. It do be hitting. Walks past and the coin machine doesn't work. It do be hitting different. Have my free seat. Anyway. What else do I want to talk about? I feel like the last few vlogcasts, I've just been talking about working, because that's all I've been doing. Like, and maybe some Dark Souls, which I think Dark Souls is slowly growing into my crush. I don't know what it is. Dark Souls is just, it's really good. Because, like, okay. Bloodborne? I've beat Bloodborne at least 10 times. I loved that game. Because it was before I got a PS4 and I didn't know if I was going to be able to get a PS4. And then I got it, and then I eventually got Bloodborne, and I was like, oh, fuck. Fuck yeah. And then I beat it like 800 times. And I never got to play I didn't get to play Dark Souls until like 2 years ago. I got stuck on No, I didn't get stuck. I got lost. I'm gonna sound like such a bitch. I got lost in the high wall of Lothric. And I was like, man, this game sucks, bro. How you give me a shield? This sword sucks. I got one weapon. I was complaining about like everything. But I found out where I was going, and then I beat the game not too long ago. Maybe like 2 or 3 weeks ago now. And I beat it with another character just recently. I beat New Game 2 times or 3 times. I think I'm an addict. I think that's my crack. I don't know what else to say. I think that's just how it is. Like, I don't know. Dark Souls is just really cool. And I have 2 videos. Can I say I have 2 videos coming out? I mean, one of them definitely exists by the time this came out. The Madeir one definitely came out by the time this did, because that's scheduled for this Friday, which is tomorrow. It feels so nice to be ahead. Fuck. And the next Dark Souls video, I haven't decided. Either it goes up Monday, which it might not, because you're gonna have to bear with me, bro. I'm talking about me from now. Because the plot thing, the tier maker thing is probably going to be up Monday. And I want the next Dark Souls video to go up the next Friday, because it's the other final boss, which I just kind of gave away who it is. This is Logcast, it doesn't matter. I'm talking about Gale. I'm making a video on Gale, which, I see a spider web in front of my face. Gale's video is probably going to be the one that when I cut this off, I'll edit it. Either I'll edit that, or I'll edit the tier maker video. What else? I guess when I'm tired, I say Bedome a lot. I didn't notice this till yesterday night when I was recording the tier maker video. And like every 5 seconds, I couldn't think of what to say. I went like, Bedome. I did it not. Like, I did it in this podcast, like, not even that long ago. And I think, it sounds stupid, because I'm saying, but I say it really fast, and it goes like, Bedome, and then I heard it once, and I was like, Bedome, and I laughed for, like, 5 minutes in the Tear Maker video, because I kept catching myself saying it, and it sounds like, Bedome, I'm so fucking stupid. I wish I wasn't, but I am. I'm a simple man. I don't know what to tell you. It was funny, though. It was funny. I don't know if I'll include those. Y'all are going to have to tell me, because I don't know yet. I think my goal for this week is to be ahead again. To be ahead another week. Because, like, I know the people who go, like, oh, I'm ahead for this week. I know a lot of them don't upload daily. And uploading daily is crazy. But, you know, I feel like I just have to be on that. I don't know what else to say. This just has to be, I have to be ahead. I only have 2 out of 5 videos done for next week. And I feel like I want that whole week done.
Just listen long enough
by Saturday. That's 3 days to make 3 videos. And that sounds horrible. That sounds really horrible. Out of context, but I think I can do it.
I'm not crazy.
If I work the way that I'm feeling like I should work right now, I don't think it'll be a problem, to be honest. Who else? I feel like I've fallen in love with keying. I don't know. I'm gonna tell you what I didn't love. If you remember a while ago, I think 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, by the time this is coming out, I believe, I made the video on when Horace kills Henri. I named it something like that. And that video took so long. I'm not even gonna lie. That video took forever. Getting all these niggas' faces right. I had to get the sizes right on the sprites. I had to fix them. It took a lot. It doesn't look like it took that much. Like, from someone from the outside, I'm assuming they're like, bro, you uploaded like a 20-second video. What are you bitching about? But that took so long. And I kept missing frames. Like, frames, you know when, like, you see something in, like, a funny animation video, and it's, like, for, like, a second, and you can notice it? I had those kind of not-keyed moments where it would just be, like, their clean face for a second. If you look at my Instagram, I uploaded an earlier version of it where there is a frame where you can see the Soul of Cinder's face disappear. And you can just see it's Kiryu. And then I messed up the placement of the... what is that thing called? The Blue Sentinel's emblem. And I placed it to the right. It was kind of ugly. I was going to just upload the video like that. And I was like, nah, you can't fucking do that. That's not thorough. So I went back and I... you know, I touched it up a bit. What else? I had another video I wanted to talk about, and I made it. Oh, the Madeir, the Madeir one. I feel like there's just so many funny jokes you can make with, like, keying and moving. Keying and keyframes. Mostly keyframes on tiny images. My editors will know what I'm talking about. But I don't know, there's so many videos that just encapsulate things. Like, there are videos with, like, thousands of views where it's just, like, a keyframed image just moving over someone's face in a funny context. And I don't know why, but I find it really funny. It takes forever to do, but I always laugh at it. So I'm like, not too many other YouTubers do that either. Not too many other YouTubers do that either. So that might just be my thing. I don't know. I think it will be, though. I kind of like it. I kind of dig it. I'm not going to lie to you. Golly. Let's talk about recordings, right? So I have 3 Dark Souls... that's a lie. I have 6. I have 6 Souls videos. I don't know if all of them are going to go up. I might scrap a few of them. But I have 6 Souls videos ready to go. 2 of which, one was the Madeir one and the other one's the Gale one. And then there's a third one that I'm not even going to tell you about, unless it exists already, which would be funny. Probably not. The Madeir video was... The raw footage, I think, was like 30 minutes. Like, about 30 minutes. The Gale video, I think, was... 40? Or less? I might be getting them confused, but... Nah, I think Madeir took longer. Madeir might have been like 40. But, I managed to get it down to... I think the Madeir video should be like... It's not that long. I think it's like 10 minutes. Like, I accidentally perfectly hit the ad time. That was not intentional. I remember looking at the scheduled videos and I saw the timing and I was like, oh shit, really? It was like 10 minutes and 1 second. I'm like, oh, that's wild. And most of it was because of the outro. That wasn't even meant to be a sleazy thing. I don't even have ads yet. Like, no one could even come at me and say that, but I don't know. That was funny. It caught me off guard. I'm hearing someone talk outside and threw me off. I wanted to talk about copyright claims. That's such a horrible thing to have to jump to. Talk about ads and then just go to copyright claims. Copyright claims, if you're a smaller YouTuber, copyright claims aren't that bad. They're not, you know, they're not gonna kill you or anything, right? Because basically it's just when someone puts their ads on your video. So if you see an email saying you got copyright claimed, it's like, okay, that's not too bad. Did I mention this before? I don't think I did. Most copyright claims aren't too bad. Most of them, right? I got one from Japan not too long ago for the SAO Part 2, because I used Unravel, the Tokyo Ghoul opening, it wasn't even the whole song. I think it was like, it was less than a minute, I think. And they blocked my whole video, so I had to re-upload it. And when I re-uploaded it, I got claimed by another Japanese company. The one, what are they called? VT? I'm guessing they made the Fist of the North Star soundtrack. And in my head, I'm like, bro, that show is like 40 years old. I guess Japan just be like that. Because their copyright laws are different. So they can just do that. So if you're an upcoming YouTuber, I recommend, if you want to use soundtracks, I recommend you use things from video games or things that say they are free library, open source, copyright free. Because Japan do not play that. If you use any anime music, you're not getting money for it. They won't copyright strike you usually, but they'll claim it. they'll claim your video. They'll do that. they don't care. One time I got claimed by a company. It was more than 4 years ago, and I clicked on a link because I think in the claims they give you a link to what the company does, and I saw I ended up seeing some yaoi manga, and I'm like, what? This is where my money is going? You claim me for this? Nothing against, you know, yaoi, but I'm like, you took my money to make some yaoi? Like, come on. That was back when I was monetized, too. That's so foul.
Wait a second.
Oh, man. That was horrible. If you want to know someone who's been claimed more than me, I don't know if they exist. I've been claimed a lot. A lot of my old videos got claimed. The only fear that I would have is if I blew up and then I got striked down for using songs when I got big, but I don't think they can do that. Like, after claiming. Usually you'll just be like, strike, and then that's it. I think... I'm not going to say anything. But I don't... I think I've been striked once. A long time ago. But I don't... I'm not sure on that. Because I think... The thing with strikes is strikes are manual. I do believe. Claims... Strikes are manual or they're done by a company. Claims, I think... Claims are when they run through the system and they hear a song and then they'll just send a claim at you. It's, you know, it's whatever. But yeah, I'd be so mad if I hit like 1K and then I instantly got fucked up by by strikes. I'd be like, oh man. I'd be like, come on, guys. That's out of pocket, to be honest. What else do we have to talk about? What else do we have to talk about? I guess we're going back to the Madeir video. I found out how to do the funny voice effect. You know when it goes up and down, they're like, well, you know, I wonder, your feet sting. Like that. I found out how to fully do that in the Madeir video, and I'm like, that's kind of hot. I think I'm going to use that more too. I don't know. It's really funny. It's funny. It's a funny meme. I know some people go like, it's not funny. I'm like, I find it funny. You're on my channel. Get off me. Golly, let me have some freedom.
Wait a second.
Oh. Speaking about my channel. Again. Not the Madeir video this time. Vlogcast. Soundtrack. Oh, this goes perfectly with the copyright claim thing. I should have not talked about the other thing first. The last Logcast, episode 3, it got claimed by 3 different people, and I'm like, go off. I guess you're taking my ad money now, whoever you are. So I'm thinking about making mixes in the upcoming week for the Logcast to be used in the background. I was thinking about using some of the already established ones, not the intense ones, not like Rose theme, because that doesn't fit the aesthetic we got. I was thinking more of the DJ Subatomic one, which is my favorite mix, but I'll get into that after I'm done this point. I was thinking about using chill ones like that, but then I noticed I don't have that many calm ones. Like, I think most of them are Rose theme, and the other ones are DJ Subatomic theme, like mixed with something. There's the Persona one, which that doesn't fit the vibe here. I'm trying to think. I really am. You know, those mixes. A lot of the newer ones that I uploaded, I made a while ago. I just didn't make a thumbnail for them. I don't know. Because I would have been like, let me use the Kingdom Hearts one, because I had one. I had the perfect one for y'all. But I couldn't get the audio to come out right. It was Code Vein and Kingdom Hearts. The shit was not working with me. I did it like 5 different times and it was not happening. And I'm like, oh god. And after like 3 days of just fiddling with it, I'm like, this isn't gonna work. I'm just gonna have to erase this. I have the thumbnail. It's still in my phone and I liked it. And I'm sad I couldn't use it because I got cucked by audio. I blue-balled by my phone. But, that happened. what I was going to say before about the DJ Subatomic. Bro, I think that is my favorite mix. I like the music make you lose control. That one was funny. That one was funny. I always forget that I did that because I made it not wanting to like it and then I liked it. But I don't like it like that. The Subatomic Speedway one, and that's always going to be its name in my heart. I love that one. I should make that my ringtone to wake up in the morning. That thing slaps. I love it. That's my baby. That's my child right there. I think it has the most views out of all the mixes too. No, it doesn't. The other one did. The other one that I did because it reminded me of a childhood memory. That one got the most views. What is it called? The Rune Factory and the Epic 7 one has the most views, because Subatomic Speedway got, let's get to work. I looked at it not too long ago. It got like 150. The Rune Factory one got 200 something. And I'm like, I like Rune Factory. I know nothing about Epic 7. But Subatomic Speedway though, come on y'all. Come on y'all. Y'all know y'all love some Subatomic Speedway. I'm just saying. It was fire. It was fire. I hope it gets more recognition down the line. I might advertise it more again. I know it's old, but man, I love it, bro. I don't know. It's because it was like the first mix. That's one part. It turned out really good. That's the other part. And I don't know. You know how people go like, music's meant to take you somewhere. I'm going to sound like such a dramatic. But I don't know. Y'all gonna have to bear with me. I'm gonna sound stupid right now. But I was sitting in my bed one time, and it cut on. Like, I think it was in my autoplay or something, because I have all of my mixes, or most of them, downloaded to my phone. And it cut on, and I closed my eyes, and I saw myself at the place where I wanted to be. You know what I'm saying? Like, I saw where I want to be, and I think I just started editing after that. I was like, oh shit, oh fuck. Like, if I hear that song, it just reminds me of where I want to go and what I'm gonna have to do to get to where I want to go. But I don't know, that song, it does something to me. I don't know what it is. It's not even like in my top 10 songs ever, but it does something to me. Might just because it's mine, might not because of that, but it's wild. It's wild. Let's get to work. I know some people go like, that's what rap music triggers in me, bro. I don't know. It hits different. I guess when you make something and you really like it, it just hits different. On the subject of something hitting different, I might have mentioned it in a previous vlogcast. I think I did. The Subatomic voiceover. I think I mentioned it, so I'm gonna speed it. But it came on my phone, right? And I'm not gonna lie, the audio mixing, it wasn't that good. It was passable. You could understand what I was saying if you'd listened. And my delivery was kind of flat, just a little bit. That's the thing, right? Everyone's a critic. Like, I'm not a professional voice actor, obviously. As you can tell from the fact I've only done 2 dubs on my whole channel. But, I don't know. I don't hate that video, because I know a lot of people would cringe at it, like, oh my god, he's trying to be the big-shouldered the big-shouldered fuzzy-legged tube nigga. Like, look at him, point and laugh, but I like that video. I know it's, like, low-key cringy, my delivery wasn't great, but I wanted to do that, and then I did it. And I can't even bring myself to hate it. If I listen to it now, I'll end up smiling. Especially just the part where I was like, DJ Subatomic Supernova, bro. I heard that part back, and I was like, oh, that's not good. At the time, I think I was like, man, I nailed that line. And I listened to it, I was like, nah. you kind of missed your mark on that one. I didn't put enough emotion into it. But, you know, I love it. I always end up smiling whenever I hear that part. Like, I'll be like, it's this video. And then I'll hear DJ Subatomic Supernova. And I'm like, oh shit. There I go. Go off me. I don't know what that is. It's, I don't know. Same with the Raiders video. Well, I mean, they were meant to sound flat in that, right? Because they were all voiced by, like, one guy, and he was just like, oh, you know, the red, it's not red. I think it's more of a blue. Like, he was meant to sound like that. So that one, I mean, it happened. I don't know. I look back more on the Subatomic Supernova one than I do the Raiders one. I'm happy I did both of them. And the Raiders one was more of a test on sound design than, you know, voice acting and inflections and all that. Because I mentioned it. I remember talking about this in, like, the first podcast. But I didn't mention it fully. I had to re-add all the sound effects so my audio didn't sound, like, super terrible. Because I knew if it was just me talking, you'd go like, oh, this is kind of weird. So I had to re-add the fire, the gunshots, the vertebird coming in. And I'm proud of myself for doing that, but I don't look back as fondly on that video as I do on the Subatomic video. I feel like it's just because I put my everything into it. And even though it's not that good, it's got my seal of approval. Enough of that. Enough of that topic. I don't know how long I've been talking for. I feel like I've been talking for a minute. For a grit. I'm gonna look at my clock. If it says 2, I've been talking for a while. It doesn't say 2. I'm still A-okay. Probably been 30 minutes. 30, 20? 40, fuck. Okay, we're going on an hour. Yo. What else? This is why I shouldn't look at the time, because it makes me go like, oh damn, this is a long ass video. I feel like we've covered all the bases. Getting motivated. We hit the high low high of the week, you know what I'm saying? I might make a bloopers video soon. Because I mentioned it last time, I think, how I have audio for since the SAO video, and I want to use it. And now I have even more, because I had 2 incidents when trying to open up this log cast, bro. I literally, when I was testing out the mic's audio, I leaned backwards, and my whole chair said, yeah, yeet, and it almost threw me off. I'm like, oh, bro. Oh, bro, what a bro moment. One more thing about chairs. I promise this will be the last thing, because I feel like I've talked about everything I've wanted to talk about. I'll probably cut off this recording and go like, oh my god, I forgot to talk about the, you know. But whatever, that usually happens. About this chair. I'm sitting like L. I didn't start off sitting like L, but I'm sitting like L now. But this is an office chair, I think. I was gifted it a long time ago. I want to say 2, 3, 4 years ago. And I didn't even sit on it like that till recently, because I didn't start sitting down and working until recently. And this shit is all kind of scratched. And I'm trying to figure out how it gets scratched. And I don't sit on it. I don't get it. Like, where the other one? The other armrest is behind me. The other armrest, the left armrest is fine. Allow me to show you something. I think I might be dumb. I think this is my left. Whatever. It's not like you can see the chair. You don't know that I'm stupid. The left armrest is, it looks like a cat just came in it. Like, just crick, like, right across the whole side of it multiple times, and it's, like, all chipped and crazy. And then there's the bottom part where your butt goes, and that's all scraped up, too. And I'm like, bro, who put the razor ass on my chair? Like, why? Not everything else is fine. I don't know why it's like that, to be honest. Like, what, you get hurt from age? Like, I didn't do that. Granted, there's been like two other people who may have sat in this chair. But I don't know, like I said, y'all are razor ass. Like, I don't know how that happens.
Allow me to show you something.
Anyway, I think this has been a good Logcast. Very positive. I know I had that little in between about, you know, peer pressure, but that's, yeah, everything else has been mostly chill this week. My anxiety's gone down since this week is done, and I don't have to worry about anything else for this week. I just gotta worry about next week. So the next wave of anxiety comes in. But yeah, I'm gonna pick up the phone so we don't have something like the first broadcast where I had to say, love y'all, see y'all, and then I was like, oh shit, the phone. Yeah, we're at 50 minutes and 52 seconds. So, let's hurry this up. Love y'all, see y'all. Press like and subscribe. We're gonna have an end card here now. You know, we got a budget. Not really. And I hope to see y'all next time. Bye!